Hello, welcome to today's video. I'm working on the shirt. Rock will finally have a shirt. Check it out. He does have a shirt so far. So you can get the shirt item, and the shirt item basically protects you from some harm. It sometimes blocks about a half tooth worth of damage. Sometimes you get pretty lucky too, so if you get hit normally for just one damage, sometimes it will actually make you invincible for that one damage instead of having it. So when it gets down to the smallest amount, it randomly rolls whether or not to hurt you. So anyways, I'm working on this art where for the shirt, there is a whole new system here at work, because adding the shirt actually adds a lot of frames. So before there were like 1500 frames for Rock. Now there's going to be more for sure. You see, by adding the shirt, I've added 1, 2, 3 frames there, 3 frames there, 3 frames here, 3 frames here. So that's 4 sets of animations to just this one idle south, because it has to have the combination of the shirt, the sheath shirt, the sheath, the hat shirt, the hat sheath shirt, the hat sheath, the hat, and the nothing. So there's a whole lot of stuff being loaded, and it gets loaded here using these different skins. So this new system scans an animation, like you put in this star character here, wherever you want in the animation's format, and then it goes and tries to load in each one of these different words, and whichever ones it finds, it registers those as animations that are available for this profile. That's how this new system works. But it's requiring a lot of work to go back and re-export all of Rock's frames, make sure they're all working with this new system, changing just simply the format of them all to work with this new system. So there's a lot of work here. All right, so I just did melee. Wait, did I finish melee? I think I'm still working on the melee. Okay, so melee it is. We did 0 south. Let's verify that. Rock sword, 0 south. So I just exported these. Oh yeah, okay, that's got a sword, it's got a sword. Sometimes when these are exported, they gotta be, because of the new system, there's a new script I use here in Photoshop to export all the frames, and sometimes that can be a little bit sensitive to things like, you know, the sword animations can't have a sword group and stuff like that. So anyways, I'm going through and making sure each one of these animations is just working right with the new system. So I have to ungroup those sword layers, so it doesn't think that's a separate skin. Now I'm running the export script. Okay, I'm gonna do all 3 of these at once. Okay, so I verified the south. Here's north. Yeah, it's got the sword. Okay, it's to east. Yeah, okay. North half. Oh, running turn maybe. What the heck was that animation? No. There it is. It's melee two. Aha, where are we? One east? Why is one east north? Well, this is so confusing. Okay, it seems to have fixed it here. So yeah, this is probably going to take all day. I've already been working on this a whole half day just to get to this point, and now it's just basically a lot of work to get every one of these frames all working. But the biggest parts are done. The code part's done. It's mostly just like okay, cool. Oh, it's good. All right, the Perry animations. So here's the process. Basically, now that it's got this smart new system, I can delete these extra hatless ones and just change this word hat here to star. And since this is already an animation that's already been rendered, Perry should already work. I guess we can check that. Here. Okay, cool. I saw him do a parry there. Okay, let's check in to Mimi. Just making sure all these files look reasonable. Sometimes I'm like, oh, why are there 10 extra frames? And it, you know, it's because of an animation having the wrong timing or something. This looks good. We added 7 new frames or 8 for each one of these shirt animations for swinging the sword with the shirt. We can add all those. Commit the data part of this all. So it's been a lot of check-ins like this today, just like hundreds of ping files updated and new. Update rocks. Okay, we got parry, charge. Need to be able to charge now. Charge sword. Okay, so we've ignored these hatless animals. There was a special case here, possibly. Let's see if charge actually works as it is. We got charge ability. So I was swinging the sword and holding it there. I think what's happening is it's not finding this animation. This render system get an M key returns us the charge animation. And then we check if we have it active. And doesn't have that animation. So there's no just regular charge. I guess that means we need to duplicate all these. This is a special case I haven't encountered yet. I think it means this. We need to have a regular animation and the sword animation because these are distinct. And all of these need their variants. Cool. So that's the whoops. Got stuck. Okay, so now we need to get the other animations in these working. Like charged and uncharged. Oh, these might be wrong. Charge like with patch. Oh yeah, these have not been exported. Okay. So yeah, good thing I checked these. These swords need to be ungrouped. And then re-export these. Shoot. I don't think this is going to export, right? Yeah, the glow is missing. Because it's a group that it thinks is not shouldn't be part of. Wait, what if I call it body? That hopefully will work around this little quirk in the exporter script. Oh, cool, it worked. Nice. For these ones that got these doubles, I guess we'll just call that body then. What the heck are these? I don't think these are anything. Last time I edited it was recently? What? I just never used these, maybe? It's called Charge 2. I don't think I use these. So also part of this is the uncharge. That's definitely in there. Yeah, so this script is basically fleshing out the missing animations, the shirt animations. The shirts were all there. All the animations were finished. It's just that they need to be exported correctly. Looks like it finally got bigger than it expanded. It's twice as large now. It does take a second. How many frames are we up to? 4,000? Holy crap. There's almost 5,000 frames for one character. Well, next time maybe I'll design a better system where I don't have to export every single one of these things as a separate. But this keeps it real simple. You know, you can load one, play one animation without having to like combine them all at runtime or whatever. But combining them all at runtime would save up on the number of frames overall. But still, there's, look how much room there is left here. So much room. All right, if this all works, then we should have all the charge animations. Without the hat. So we've added a bunch of animations for the charge attack. With the shirt. Okay, celebrate, uncelebrate. We're not gonna need the hatless or sheath hatless. And this never happens with the sword. So this is actually gonna be quite a simple animation here. Celebrate, uncelebrate. Now we just need to find an item. Let's go to like dungeon one. I'm sure there'll be a key somewhere. Oh. Cool, so that was celebrating with the shirt. My shirt. Oh, okay. So the celebrate animations just need to be re-exported. Thank you. actually had the right animation there, even though there was kind of some weirdness. It's kind of a weird situation to get an item without your hat anyway. But I should check it. So this one, we need the shield to test this out. This one looks good. Man, there's a lot of frames being added here. So after this is all said and done, I'll have to play the whole game basically with the shirt, play the whole game without the shirt. Just make sure that everything works. Everything that Rocky used to be able to do, he can still do and look like he used to do for the most part. Was kind of a big one. Like it took up a lot of room. Courage with the shirt. So that would be getting a life container without the sword, without the shirt. Okay, so we never had that animation. Floating animations, eat animations, sheath, unsheath, pushing, hurt, edging, parrying, flask, wake up, sit, unsit, meditate, drop, knees, lighter, blink, fire blink, ice blink. Shit, there's a lot more to do today. Pick up, teleport, board, dash, stairs, lift, leave sword. God damn. It's gonna be a long ass day. lucky guess. All right, take a little quick break. Some of these animations are going to go faster than the others, like this one. There's no sword. Cool. The unsheath and the sheath, finally. This will be a nice continuity. Oh, guess we'll need a sword for that. Oh, we need the sword versions too. So I'm adding an empty sheath group to each one of these animations. It is faking it. There's nothing in it. It's just, it duplicates the animation for the sheath series of animations. So it just makes the whole new system just automatically pick up those animations as a separate animation. And when it gets packed into Texture Packer, it recognizes them as duplicate frames, and it all kind of washes out. Doesn't increase the texture memory at all. So like now there's the unsheath east shirt as well as the east sheath shirt, but they're the same thing. South. So I'm going to check in a couple files just to simplify things a bit. Let's review that. So I added the format to the load animation. Instead of the load animation grabbing the format's passed into the load animation, and the load animations parses any skins. If there are no skins, the skins vector will be empty. And then it loads that format and auto detects if it has a star in it. And then if it does, it loops over the skins and tries for all those skins and then loads an animation. Otherwise, if there is no star in the format of the animation, it uses the old system where it just loads the animation using the exact format that is manually specified. So there's like an auto load format and a manual load format, and then the ability to be verbose or not. And this is new, where it checks if it has the frames before it pushes it back into the animation. Okay, but that's good for now. Input system. Well, That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.